Everybody, welcome back to another video. So today we're playing Plane Crazy and I'm gonna show you how to make the tank without wheels. So the end of the tank will look like this. So this tank is generally very good to PvP, as you guys can see. You can shoot. It's fast. So first we will need a 13 block long pole. So just like this. Then we need to take wedges. So we will need many of them. So place them on each corner like this. This will be the track. So then place a block on top. Place another wedge. And place a block again. Then take wedges. We need four this time. Put one like this and one like this. The other do the same. Then connect your tank sides, tank track sides. So now that they're connected, this is one of our tracks. Make sure you cover it up though. So the inside you put wedges so it looks smooth. This is the first one, now they blocks. And place them so it's blocked all the inside. We need it for building. And then on the bottom here, skip one block so it's one block less on each side. So this is our wheel from the back. Now take cylinders, take the half cylinder. Make sure it's rotated in this direction and then place them like so, like this. This is like our tank tracks, like this, and then copy it on the other side. So now you guys will have to choose how long you want to make it. It depends on how wide you want to make your tank. So I will make mine here. So then just copy the other track. Now the bowl is done again. Now we need to take the wedges and the blocks. Then take your wedges again, of course. We just need to copy the other one. So this will be our second track. Now these tracks will not move us because our movement will be with rocket engines. Just like this, then connect them again. Like this. So now take your wedges, build the inner edges like this so it's smooth. We need to make it look nice. And just copy the top also. Do the same for the bottom here, so this will be our second track again. Place this underneath. Make sure it don't mess up like I did. So now take your cylinders. Make sure they're like this again. Place them. This is our second tank track. Then you have to build the tank main body. So depending on how long you made it, you have to connect it now. I will connect it with longer blocks so it's faster. So on underneath this will be our movement system, and on top of it will be our tank turret. So make sure every single piece is nicely connected. Like this. And you guys can see we have our main tank body finished. Now take the motor number 2, so this tank will be controlled by your cursor. And now find the place you want the center of it to be, so in case you want to know, it's best if it's in the middle of your tank. Then make sure your yellow thing is pointed outwards and the thing is down. So now start building your turret body. Just don't make it too big, otherwise not cool. It should fit the general size of the tank though, otherwise it would look out of order on our epic tank. So we need to make it a bit bigger from the back. This is good enough. Now make it long, so we need to fit our cannon on here also. This is good. Now take wedges. Make sure they're like this, so this will be a 3D turret, so it looks very nice from the outside, in my opinion. So now take a block and place it on top of every single one of them. Take wedges again, and this time make sure they're inwards, like this. Turn to the other side also. So this tank is pretty good in terms of PvP. Do a second layer also. So right now our tank looks like this, then take wedges again so it looks nicer from the outside. Make sure they're positioned correctly. So like this. Other side also. Now just connect the both sides up. Make sure you leave a bit of space for our cannon so it can move up and down. Then This is our bag. Just fill this in. Make sure you don't get stuck inside the tank. So this is our main tank turret. Cannon party completed. So now here our cannon will be one white. So if here's one, then it's not enough, as you guys can see. So we can make two cannons. Now take the mortar too. So position it just like this. Like this. And place a block here. So this will be the basic block. Now put the PvP weapons you want. I will put guns and rockets into it. So rocket. It doesn't need to be on top or anything, because we will hide this. So this will be the length. You guys can also make it longer. Now take these disconnectors and put all of them. But just don't put them below, because below they will fall off for some reason. These disconnectors will make it look nice, trust me. Also on top. Take a wedge again. Make sure it's positioned like this. So this is our cannon completed. So now we need to make our steering system. So you guys can decide if you want to leave this open or not. I will personally close it so they won't see my engines. And the enemy doesn't know where to fire to break your movement. Then take the super rocket engines. Place them. So there's two space here. In each corner. Like this. As you guys can see, I did it wrong, so there is not. Then you can place another one in the middle if you guys want. For extra speed. Make sure that all align correctly. This side, you guys can put this. So this will be our movement system. So to go forward, first click on the super rocket engines that are pointing forward. So increased power will be W, but this will be left alt. And then turn only on off only mode on. Then do the same for all the front facing ones. Not for the ones that turn left or right. So in this case, we turn right, so increase power, we will need this, and left also. This left, decrease power doesn't really matter because we have on and off mode, so here do the opposite, and still left out. Just like this. And then you guys need to take your seat. You can put it wherever you want. I will try to put it into the turret body. Make sure it's aligned correctly. So now launch your tank. Press G for it. And as you guys can see, we have a tank. It moves left and right. So this was it. Have a good day and bye bye.